Hi, welcome to our show.
Well, hi, everybody!
Coming to you somewhat live and semi-weekly from the Quad M World Headquarters located in Helena's scenic North Valley, it's the Quad M Show. Here are your hosts, TJ and Marty.
Hey, kids! Sorry we've been gone for so long. I apologize and all that type of stuff, you know, but we'll get into the reasons why here after a little bit, and all that shit. But before we get into all that, little housekeeping to do here.
Nice.
First off, for all you kids out there, we have teamed up with Podchaser to provide you, the Quad M listeners, with exclusive access to the beta version of Podchaser. Podchaser gives you the ability to rate and review individual podcast episodes and discover new shows based on trending episodes. Get your nary ass over to beta.podchaser.com and enter the key Quad M to get early access to the beta. That's Quad M, all lowercase. No spaces, no fancy shit, nothing like that.
Just like it sounds.
Just Quad M, baby. We would very much like and appreciate an episode review from you, so other listeners can discover the show that you love so bad. We'd also just love to hear you, get the feedback from you from other episodes and all that type of shit. Yeah. So, please, hey, head
it's
on.
It's a win-win for everyone.
Everybody involved. So head on over there, beta.podchaser.com, and enter that key, Quad M. Quick little update. Mm-hmm. Really? Mm-hmm. Is there mayhaps? Talk to our good buddy, Mark Piokas.
Oh, yeah.
Had a little tete-a-tete with him.
Yeah?
Get a little update on River Rats.
Nice.
The major motion picture. featuring myself and Jason.
And Jason and my house.
And Marty's house.
My wife was in that one too.
Yeah, you know,
she's got a little cameo.
Yeah, and it was, you know, I believe it was in the scene that we shot in the convenience store.
It was.
And it was before I was really buddy-buddy with her. Mm. So I didn't even realize that she was...
That it was her?
There, yeah.
You just thought she was a customer?
I had... No. I figured... there was like five or six different people that were there between extras and people in the movie and the this and that. Mm-hmm. That, you know, it was just like, dude... You know, me and Jason just showed up and was like, okay, do you got your lines memorized? It's like, well, kind of. I was like, dude, okay, we got the script. We just fucking roll
We're
with
golden.
It. We'll roll with it. We're good. But, so apparently he's got himself a couple of reshoots going on. And then some final editing. I think he said he was looking at, end of summer, hopefully. Somewhere around maybe August.
Cool.
But, we'll keep you posted.
Damn.
I'm not holding any breath.
No.
Because he said originally it was going to be June. So, you know,
yeah.
and believe me, I have no right to sit there and bust balls on anybody's projects. Missing deadlines and shit. I got no room to fucking talk. So, you know, there's that.
No, I'm excited. I want to see it.
But also, too, just to let you kids know, I believe the movie was 4 months till fight night.
Yes.
Maybe I should have went and looked at it, but I got it on DVD. So, should have looked at it before. You know this, so I make sure I had the name right. But anywho, the 4 months till fight night is actually going to be available on Amazon.
Oh.
If it's not already.
Yeah.
So get on out there and check that out. You can check my motion picture debut. The butt. Do a little voiceover action on that one. Did a little JR commentary on a fight that this chick was watching, you know, her dad was fighting in, and I'm like, you know, you can hear me, you know, oh my God, Stone Cold! Oh God, King, he got out the brass knucks, oh God!
He's done.
Oh, hellfire and brimstone! You know, there was a little bit of that. but then also, too, apparently there's like this fight scene. And you know, he had the ref and, you know, was doing the deal there.
Uh-huh.
But apparently there was, like, in the original audio, there was music being played in the background.
Uh-huh.
And he either A, didn't want to get the licensing, or B, couldn't get the licensing.
Yeah.
So with that being said, he needed to do a little ADR work, as the pros call it. Get somebody in the voice booth.
And he knows a guy.
He knew a guy. And I says, yeah, sure. So I did my best Mortal Kombat.
Yeah.
You know, down there, fight. Finish him. You know?
Nice.
So, you know, we did all that. You know, we got it through. So we were a little tardy on this week's episode. And it wasn't like we took a break on purpose.
Yeah.
But as we kind of go through here, I think it was what like last week, you know, Tuesday you were a little tired.
I was super tired Tuesday.
A little tired.
I had a long day.
And then you forgot you had a softball game.
A softball game, yeah. I never remember. They have to remind me the day of.
You know, yeah, it's priorities. I got a show to record. Oh wait. I got to go hit a big beach ball and drink beer. Sorry kids. Sorry TJ.
Softball's like my one getaway. It's the one thing I'm good at.
So, past that, beyond that, how was the rest of the week for you?
It was good. It was really good. It was 4th of July weekend, so we went out and camped a bunch. Worked Friday night, but I got the rest of the weekend off. And yeah, we hung out. We blew some shit up. And yeah, we had a good time at the lake.
Yeah?
It was awesome. Yeah.
Not too bad a deal. I know you were telling me off screen, off air, about a little artillery shell incident.
Oh, yeah. Of course, you know, when you drink all day long and then you decide to light fucking fireworks off at 11 o'clock at night. And you get about fucking 13 people down where you're lighting fireworks off. Shit, bad shit's about to
maybe something might
bound
happen.
To happen. Yeah. Yeah, so, but I wasn't down there for that part. That was some other people, and just an artillery shell got thrown in upside down, you know. But fuck, man, it's war. It's Independence Day.
That's right. That's right. Happy birthday, America. America.
Fuck yeah. Yep. No one got hit. No one got hurt. So we took a 15-minute break and pulled our heads out of our asses and
covered up the crater.
Yeah. Oh, that it just destroyed the 2x6 that it was screwed down to.
Jesus Christ.
Just destroyed it. Yeah, it was awesome.
Well, you know mine wasn't nearly as fun or enjoyable.
No,
not so much. Basically what it amounts to is, and I've told you kids a million times, you know, in the past couple months, you know, kind of been passing a lot of the time. Been having computer issues. Is the computer, you would want to shut off like every 10 to 15 minutes and just restart. And like the last two episodes we recorded were just struggles to get through. You know, like, oh, shit, got to stop, pause, save and save.
It. That's a good stopping point.
Which I'm thinking, this is like the third time with this section, so I'm thinking that's going to fucking, might be a deal.
It's going to be the norm for
us. But at least now I know it's, I think it's the recording software that's causing the issue this time. Because
right.
It wasn't doing it up until this.
This.
So I'm thinking that's where the problem lies.
Yeah.
But we'll find out.
It would make sense.
We'll see. So anyways, going through having to deal with all the bullshit, and it was pissing me off.
Yeah,
you know, because and really in particular, not just with, you know, recording the show, but in recording or in doing Enigma work.
Yeah,
it would perpetually shut down. Mm-hmm. While I'm working, so I would either, if I didn't hit that control save quick enough, you know, I could lose upwards of, you know, sometimes an hour's worth of work because I'd forget to hit the old control S real quick to save shit.
Yeah.
And it finally got to the point where, God, I want to say it was probably Saturday or Sunday where the final straw was hit, but, It did its fucking crash and restart and all that bullshit. And then the entire page that I had been working on, because I think we had talked about this before, mm-hmm. in that I was going to basically have these two pages done, give, you know, a little bit more work for, you know, Jason to get shit done, and I could feel better about myself and the world, and shit was good. And then this page, gone.
No!
The fucking crash decided to turn it from a Photoshop file to a temp file, unreadable, a day's worth of work, down the fucking toilet.
Fucking bullshit!
And with a lot of this, I'm not going to get too technical, because I don't want to bore people and put them to sleep, except for you. You know who you are. So with that, I finally just had the fucking final straw. Mm-hmm. And prior to this, I had been doing a lot of various little things to try to figure out what in the hell was going on. What was the fucking deal?
Mm-hmm.
And so, with the help of good friend of the show, old Jamie Bronson,
yes,
got some tips, pointers, things about how to what we need to fucking do.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure you want to hear that conversation, don't you?
Of course.
God damn, you fucking noob. You crazy geek fish. What the fuck?
The fuck's your problem?
God damn.
Can't figure that out?
Can't do this shit on your fucking own. You gotta come to me with this shit. What the fuck? Fucking noob. You know, this wouldn't happen if you quit watching all that goddamn gay porn. Fucking gay fish.
Nailed it.
So anyway, I jest. But so, went through and did a bunch of uninstalls, reinstalls on various devices and programs and this and that. Nothing was fucking working.
Yeah.
And I tried everything fucking humanly possible for this fucker.
Yeah.
So
did you sacrifice a chicken?
Damn near. Had some wings.
Had some wings.
If that counts.
Does in my book.
Love me barbecue. So finally I said piss on it. And initially I was just going to try and do a simple Windows repair, thinking mm-hmm. maybe it was a Windows issue.
Yeah.
Well, that wasn't so much the deal there. So instead I said, finally, I just said, fuck it. And am just going to reinstall Windows 100%. Not going to deal with this bullshit no more.
Yeah.
So this was a couple days ago. Now, as we're recording this, it's July 5th, yeah. Wednesday the 5th. So this would have been, I think, Monday night.
Mm-hmm.
And basically going through and trying to get this fucker reinstalled 6 times.
Well, no shit.
It would continuously time out. It would do its error out, crash, come back up bullshit. I mean, it was just across the board. Finally, after about the 6th time, everything finally came through.
Yeah.
No, I mean, it got to a point where it was ready, it was this and that, and then it fucking cuts down. So then the fucker decides it's just going to go on this endless loop of turn on and just give me a blue screen, then turn off, turn back on, blue screen, turn off.
The red ring at that.
Oh, Jesus. Dude, you have no fucking idea, man. Oh, I was pissed. So, finally, everything's back running. Everything's smooth. Everything's just fucking crystal golden.
Mm-hmm.
12 shades of awesome.
Hey, baby. Love you.
I love you. Thank you.
I'm sorry for what I said earlier.
I didn't mean it, baby. I didn't mean it. And so, so then with that, everything pretty much good to go. Mm-hmm. So then I spent all of last night, yes, kids, July 4th, I did not get to go and shoot fireworks and blow shit up. No, I was busy working. Because let's be honest here, kids. If Quad Am ain't producing content, which my computer requires, then it ain't much of a fucking production company.
Not
so so with that mind, basically it was getting all the updates loaded on, and that took fucking 2.5 hours in and of itself. I went and visited your ma-in-law.
Nice. The old Cece.
Yep.
Cece.
Went and had myself a quick drink because I figured 2.5 hours to kill.
Boom.
15 minutes, we're only at 5% complete. Well, guess what? Look outside, it's about 10:30. There ain't nothing. Fireworks are dwindling enough that I don't have to worry about a rocket coming through my windshield.
Mm-hmm.
So I go and I just have myself one, and we're all good in the hood.
Bullshitted.
And just hang out for a little bit, come back. I think by the time I came back, it was about, 60% complete. So I go ahead and I let it finish, and then it was reinstalling all the drivers and all this fucking minutia that none of you folks out there could really give two shits about. So then at this point in time, it's reinstalling programs, which I, there's still some stuff I have to reinstall, like my Microsoft Office and all that type of stuff. But as we're recording now, it's wanting to start doing this fucking kickoff thing again, and I'm pretty sure it's the recording software.
Yeah.
Because it wasn't doing it before.
That sucks.
It wasn't doing it before. So I'm thinking it might be the recording software is okay, but the updates are fucking something up.
Mm-hmm.
Could be. So once we're recorded, this is all done, TJ's gonna
do
play
some more
a little bit.
Investigating.
TJ's gonna play a little bit because
I got a feeling.
And that tonight's feeling gonna be a good night. Oh, Jesus Christ. No, I am not fucking playing Black Eyed Peas for a pound.
Tonight's the night. Let's live it up.
Yeah, I am not fucking.
That's a great song.
Oh,
come
Jesus
on.
Jesus Christ, dude. Really?
You've never been totally shit faced dancing to that song?
No. No.
Well, you should try it sometime.
I have been. You know, I haven't been shit-faced dancing since probably the turn of the century.
PJ.
Well, this is back when we had the dance club.
Oh yeah.
Out there in the
DJs?
Downtown area.
DJs.
It used to be JD's.
JD's Bullwhackers.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've frequented that place.
Oh, when I turned 21, shit, dude.
Yep.
I was a fucking wreck. it was pretty much every night. My girlfriend at the time, you know, she didn't turn 21 for like another 3 months. Oh, she was pissed.
I'm sure.
You're going to go out all the fucking time, and I just okay. Okay.
Get older.
Okay. Let's speed this shit up. Come on. Come on. You're in with the crowd. Get
Can't
yourself
you
a
use
fake.
Your sister's ID?
Well,
come
she,
on now.
No, she would be the sister.
Ah, damn it.
That's what happens when you're top of the food chain in the sibling department. That's all you get. But yeah, no, I got to say, it was probably about the time where I stopped hanging out there was when I pretty much, you know, gave up, you know, embarrassingly dancing like a white dude.
Huh.
I think maybe it was just around the time I turned 30, you know?
Well, I don't know. I like to dance. It's fun.
Yeah, I mean, I mean, you know, I'm okay with it.
Yeah.
Like if I'm with somebody, you know, but it's not like the younger days when it'd be like, hey, come on, get out on the floor with me, baby.
Yeah.
And let's just see what happens. Let's shake. Like, I think honestly,
I'm going to grind on you. You can either like it or not.
But either way, it's going to happen.
It's going to happen.
This is going to happen. No, I honestly truly do believe that the last song that I drunkenly danced to at a club would probably be Beyonce's Crazy in Love. If I had to narrow one down.
You had to narrow one down? Sounds like a good time.
It wasn't Black Eyed Peas, I can tell you that.
Really? Wow.
Push it. No, is that what it is? Every time I think push it, I think Salt and Pepper.
I know, so do I. But that's because we're...
Yeah, it's just stereo 80. Right now.
Yeah.
Dick Dale's guitar and all that shit.
Right. I don't know.
Well, you know what? I'm not going to push our luck any further.
Okay.
So let's go ahead. We will wrap up this first segment.
Okay.
And we will come back and give a little bit of lip service to some Fred G. Sanford and some dated hot takes.
Dated hot takes.
A week and a half old.
Sorry.
But that's okay. That's okay.
It's still prevalent in Montana.
Hey, you know what? For what it's worth, you know, that's why the internet is timeless.
Exactly.
It's there. People want to listen. It's all that shit.
For eternity.
It's Quad M Show, kids. Stay tuned.
Have you checked out quadmproductions.com lately? Quadmproductions.com is your direct access hookup to order the Enigma comic book series and download the Quad M Show podcast. Check the appearances page for upcoming events and contact us with any questions or comments. Don't be the only lonely soul who's missing out on all the fun. Visit us today at quadmproductions.com. That's quadmproductions.com.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is Marty, the official bartender of the Quad M Show, and I'd like to be your bartender too. If you're in the Helena area, stop by and visit me at the Gold Dust Bar and Casino on Cedar Street on Wednesday nights, or Bowser's on Dredge Drive Friday and Saturday nights. Use the special discount code given out during the next segment on your next visit and get a free drink courtesy of myself and the Quad M Show. I'm Marty, and I like to party.
You're listening to the Quad M Show, segment 2.
Welcome back to the second segment of this here Quad M Show. Your host, I'm TJ.
And I'm Mark.
Welcome back to the show.
And this segment is brought to you in part by Mirror Mirror Salon and Spa. Now, I know you folks are seeing the pics online and you're saying to yourselves, damn, how does TJ get that awesome hair? Well, a very small part is genetics, kids. The big credit, however, goes to Shauna and all of the fine folks over at Mirror Mirror. Now, if you're in the Helena area, feel free, stop on in. Make your reservations today. Get your hair, nail, or spa needs met. Walk-ins are always welcome. Now, as of right now, they're still doing that $5 off for any off, any special thing that you do. You get $5 off any service they provide. Right now, I believe through the end of July or August. I'll have to double check on this.
Mm-hmm.
Because we made the deal and then, you know, and then but right now, $30 facials, kids.
Who couldn't use a $30 facial?
Who couldn't use a facial, especially at only $30?
Steal.
I know so many that love facials. And they're only $30. $25 if you, well, mix and match, kids. See if they'll do it for you.
Facial.
$30 facial. I warned her too, so I'm not going to get any heat for us giggling like little fucking teenagers.
That's what we do.
Well, I told her it was going to happen. She's like, I don't care. They're your listeners.
Do it.
I make a buck. What the fuck do I care? So get on out there. $5 off any service they provide. $30 facials. That is Mirror Mirror Salon and Spa. Give them a call today. 406-603-0644. Or stop on in. 2043 North Last Chance Gulch in Helena. That's Mirror Mirror Salon and a Spa.
Check them out.
Because they do the good work.
Giving away facials.
You know who also loves...
Actually giving them away.
You know what also loves facials?
What's that?
The Fredgie Sanford Award for the week.
Yes.
Moron. You're a moron.
Idiot.
Idiot.
Dolor.
You're always this stupid and you take lessons.
The FGS Award for Excellence in Stupidity.
Dumb it.
All right. So let's go ahead here. And... Oh, see, it's been so... See, I printed all this shit off so long ago, I forgot. I have two.
Ooh.
I have two. So let's go ahead and...
Win a chicken dinner.
So let's start off by the fine folks over at CNN.
Fake news.
Well, I don't know that it's fake so much as it just... It veers. It steers in a certain direction.
Yeah. They all do.
But this one, not so much. It's not a political thing. Oh. Well, I guess kind of, but not really. So what happened here? A Czech nuclear power station seemed to focus more on looks than qualifications when they used a swimsuit contest to hire interns.
Nice. Well played, Russia.
Oh, don't say it. No, they're Czech.
Oh, Czech.
Oh, no.
Never mind then.
I had a buddy when I was in high school.
Mm-hmm.
Foreign exchange student.
Yeah.
Jan Kovarchik. Jan Kovarchik was his name. And he was very adamant. Yeah. He was Czech.
Czech.
Or no. He was Slovakian.
Okay.
Because see, Czechoslovakia
did the split. Yep.
So you had Slovakia and you had the Czech Republic. And he was very adamant. He was Slovakian.
Ah.
So another buddy of mine used to bust his balls all the time, fucking rib him like a sumbitch, calling him Jan the Mad Czech.
Jan the Mad Czech.
He's like, no, it is Jan.
Jan.
Jan. I am Slovakian. I am not one of those. And we taught him well.
Yeah.
We taught him well. We had English class together. Mm-hmm. this is priceless. I know we're veering away, kids, but goddamn, it's been a while, so we can veer all we want. So, we're in English class, right? And they'd split us into groups, and of course, we always picked who we're gonna be in a little group in, right? And during that group, during those little group times, that's when I learned how to cuss in Slovakian.
Nice.
Which really is standard amongst the bloc countries.
Mm-hmm.
Those Eastern bloc countries.
Yeah.
That's where I learned kurva.
Kurva.
That's kind of like your whore, slut.
Nice. Kurva. Thing.
Kurva.
Kurva.
And I learned that because there was also a Russian foreign exchange student, a female. Quite cute.
Yeah.
But I didn't know that, I didn't know if any of that pinko would rub off if I hit on it. So I just kind of, hey, how's it going? But he goes, yo, say the curve. She knows what that mean. And I'm like, dude, I don't want, no. And she sat, I think, like two or three seats ahead of me. And so just sitting there, and I'd like Tourette's, I'd be like, kurva! And everyone's kind of looking, and you just see this chick, like this Russian chick, three seats above, shoulders bouncing up and down, shaking from like trying to control her own laughter.
Yeah.
And you can just hear this snickering. You have two Eastern Bloc country kids that are just snickering as I'm sitting there going, kurva!
We're sorry.
He has
Tourette's.
I was not sorry at all. I was having time. But what was funny was, I taught him, and this is when I grew a love for teaching foreigners how to swear in English. Because I did this also with a Chinese coworker when I used to work at one of the retail stores. We were on a morning crew, and I taught her how to. That's a story for another day.
All right.
Save that, file it away. Save that one in the bank. Okay. That is an awesome story. Continuing with this awesome story, though. So we're in one of our little groups, and he's teaching me how to cuss in Slovakia, and I'm teaching him how to cuss in English. And it got to talking about one of these fucking wrestling trips, right? We're all in the yellow limousine, bounding down. And, of course, we had the female managers, doctor you up and do all the bullshit, right?
Oh, yeah. Take stats.
Yeah.
Wipe down mats. I know.
And no, we had to do that.
Oh, you had to wipe down your own mats?
We did. Hey, it's one of those things. That's those things that humble you, put you in your place.
Yeah.
Okay.
We were just so good, they did.
Oh, good for you.
But there was, we're sitting there talking about, maybe it wasn't revolving that. I'm not sure. But so, talking about, as high schoolers do, talking about chicks that you're, keeping company with in the biblical keeping that company.
Studying with.
And the phrase I had used was, oh no, that's where the wrestling thing comes into play. Okay, never mind. Okay. Forget. Okay. So I was talking, we were talking about the weekend, right? And this chick and I was talking about going to town on this chick, right? And he's like, what is this going to town? So I started to try to explain. And the teacher, English teacher, and she was a bitch. I can get into that fucking at another time, too. But she was a bitch. And she goes, what are you guys talking about over there? She was still young. She was like late 20s.
Uh-huh.
So she was hip. Yeah. She knew
what was going
on.
What is it going to town?
And I explained to her. I says, no, I was talking about the wrestling trip we just had. And we were on the bus and it was going to town. That's all we were saying. We were just on the bus. We were going to town, heading to town.
Quit eavesdropping.
Getting to the big city. Well, you can't really eavesdrop when you have a fucking 18-year-old Slovakian foreigner screaming at the top of his lungs, what is this going to town?
Well played, sir.
But, dude, I learned at a very young age how to cover your tracks.
That's awesome.
When you spend most of your life allowing your mouth to get you into trouble, writing checks that your ass can't cash, you learn how to backpedal real fucking quick. Thank God we can edit on this show. So anyways, back to the story. So the CEZ's Temelin Station posted photos of 10 high school graduates posing in bikinis and hard hats in its Facebook page last week. According to the post, the woman with the greatest number of likes was supposed to be crowned Miss Energy 2017.
Oh, my.
and score a 2-week internship with the company. We think the photographs are very tasteful, the company wrote in a comment on the post. The combination of beauty and the industrial environment gives an interesting result. Shockingly, people were not thrilled. You find the number of likes under half-naked pictures of a young lady as adequate and or tasteful criterion for a career opportunity and promote it as professional, one Facebook user commented. The plant, which is listed on CEZ's website as the largest power resource in the Czech Republic, apologized 2 days later on Facebook. The company wrote that all 10 women would be offered internships. Remember what I said? The art of backpedaling, kids.
Right? It's pretty genius.
When all else fails, make it right.
All right. They all get up. You get an internship. You get an internship.
And you.
You get an internship.
And you get an internship. Even me? Yes, even you.
That's what I kind of want to see pictures of these girls now. And I kind of want to know ages.
Well, obviously.
It's
well,
high
I guess
school.
I guess I mean
it
high
could
school.
Be 17.
If they're internships, they're probably 18, yeah. But they're in bikinis, so it's not like it's one of those, you know, child pornography deals.
Yeah,
that kind of depends, I think, on what the standard is for the Czech Republic. But you figure they got.
I'm sure they have beautiful women.
I'm sure they do. Eastern Bloc chicks. You can get the real frumpy babushkas, but then you can get the real good ones too.
Gymnasts.
And you know, to that being said, I did click on the link that they had offered on here for it. Yeah. The editor event shut down. Yeah, they took that fucker off of there.
Bastards.
So I was out from now on. So now I just have to resort to Pornhub for my hot Czechoslovakian barely legal teens. The purpose of this competition was to promote technical education, the post read. But if the original vision raised doubts or concerns, we are very sorry.
You done fucked up. You know that.
Wait, let me keep that up here so then that way.
But that was CNN?
That was CNN reporting that.
Nice.
All right, next one, and I don't know offhand if this came from the smoking gun or not. Again, it's been a couple weeks, so I'm not quite sure. But a Waukesha prostitution deal gone bad involved, this is awesome, involved a stabbing, $2 in quarters, edible panties, and a 70-year-old man.
Holy buckets. they know how to party.
Only on the FGS, kids, do you get this fine news-breaking reporting.
$2?
In quarters. It wasn't even folding money.
Fuck, man. I don't even accept that at a bar.
Well, you do for Shake a Day. I know, because I've done it before. Maybe I'm just a special case. Waukesha police responded to the 900 block of... Oh, fuck, I don't give two shits about that. According to the police report, a 70-year-old man, later identified as Dennis Pistorius, was stabbed by a woman in the left shoulder with a knife. The woman, 32-year-old... Oh, good God. Tidanesia. Let's go with that. Tidanesia Eubanks.
Oh, stewardess, I speak jive.
Oh, good.
Now faces criminal charges of prostitution and first degree reckless endangerment or reckless endangering safety. Pistorius was transported to the emergency room. With the apparent injury, and Eubanks was taken into custody. After meeting in Waukesha, Eubanks and Pistorius agreed to have sex for money. After the encounter, she asked for money and edible panties. Pistorius agreed to pay for her $2 in quarters, but stopped short of giving her the edible panties. Eubanks told police that Pistorius refused to give her the pair, and a physical altercation ensued. Eubanks told police that Pistorius began to search the apartment in a frantic manner, and Eubanks feared that he may be searching for a weapon. according to the criminal complaint. It was then that Eubanks reached for her knife and stabbed Pistorius before leaving the apartment.
Bitch better have my money and my edible panties.
And my edible panties.
Give them up, fool.
Page 2.
Now, page 2.
The complaint states that Eubanks took a package from the apartment before she attempted to leave.
God bless her.
God, what is with these old farts and hookers?
Dude.
There was one, God, had it been, what, 6 months ago or something like that? We had another old codger getting busted some prostitution rap. And
hey, man.
Good Lord, you'd think that the ratio is phenomenal at the old folks' home.
It is, and I've heard they, in a lot of those places, they get down and dirty.
Oh, well, down and dusty.
And that's just disgusting. But, you know, and I guess when you're 70-year-old, I'm like, what the fuck? Whatever.
Hey, you know, we'll be there eventually.
Do what I'm going to do, you know.
You know, I sit there and I look at the prospects of the ones that are my age, and it's like, God damn. I think somebody put out the meme, you know, one of those little fucking bullshit things, and I think it read somewhere along the lines of what was it was said. I'm so delusional that I think that people my age will look way older than I do, or some shit like that. I don't know. I look at it this way. People still are still putting me in my early 30s.
Yeah, that's, you know, good.
I used to be about 25-ish. Now they got me in the 30s. 30-ish. So, you know, yeah. If I can keep a decade down.
Yeah, that's not bad.
I think I'm doing okay.
Yeah.
Then they find out, like, the life of debauchery that I lead.
Yeah.
You know, aside from illicit drugs, it's pretty bad. I mean, you know, if I can diet, gone, you know, smoking, booze.
Yeah.
All the things that are, but yet I still maintain
that.
This. This oh-so photographic, highly photogenic this. So anyways, to you, the CEZ's Temelin Station, and to you, Ty, God damn it, can't people just fucking name kids normal anymore?
No, you can't.
Ty Denisha, yeah.
Denisha,
No.
Ty Denisha, yeah, that's what
you want me to spell it for you?
Sure.
This is pretty fucked up. T-I-E-D-A-N-E-S-H-I-A.
Ty Denisha
is what I'm going to have to go with. It's the only one I can think of.
Taekwondo.
Ty Denisha Eubanks. Well, and you know what? You too, Pistorius, for offering up $2 and quarters and edible
panties. Edible panties and trying to stiff her. Way to go, old man.
Well, no, he had already stiffed her. That was
them pumps. Yeah. Got it.
Yeah.
Still got it. Week and a half off. Still got it.
Congratulations. You kids are the winners of this week's Fredgie Sanford Award for Excellence in Stupidity.
You dummy.
Good on you.
Well played.
Let's get into some hot takes.
News and notes from all four corners of the pop culture world.
And the sign gotta stay hot. You gotta stay hot.
It's time for some hot takes.
Now, I don't know. These weren't really piping hot, fresh takes or anything like that. But you know what? We haven't talked about it on the show, so it's news to us.
It is.
First off, I gotta do a little self service here. A little fan self service here. My boy Derek.
Derek?
Derek Carr.
Oh,
Raiders QB,
yeah.
Baby, got himself signed. We did not talk about this. We haven't had a chance to talk.
We have not talked about this. Holy.
Because this was not this past Monday the 3rd, but the week before, the Monday before. Mm-hmm. Oh, I was jazzed. I was so ready to fucking talk about this on the show.
I'm sure you were.
I still am. We signed our boy. The world is good.
Yeah.
Dude, I haven't been this hard since high school.
Gonna suck when he blows his knee out.
Fuck you, you prick.
I am just looking back on history, and when shit happens, usually it's followed by.
It was like a high ankle break. It was about mid shin.
Yeah.
So his knees are fine.
Well,
the knees are fine. It's just the pin under the knee that you got to worry about. But he's gone through. It's you know, preseason is going to show us a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But the first couple weeks of him taking the hits, that's what's going to prove the metal.
Yeah. No, I think he's a legit player. He deserves that money.
Well, dude, Do you watch that top 100 NFL players?
Yeah.
On NFL Network?
Yeah.
Number 11, bitches.
I know.
Beat out Dak Prescott.
Yeah. Well.
So eat it, Cowboy fans.
This is going into his fifth year now, then?
This would be, yes.
Because he, yeah.
Well, see, okay, hold on. Let me backtrack on this. Because his rookie year was the 2014 season.
One of the worst.
I remember this. Oh, God, no. That's not even close to the worst in Raiders history.
I thought they won like two games.
Three. Oh, we were 3-13. Oh. We were 3-13.
Sorry.
No, we had one season. I think we were 2-14.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe. 3-13 is not the worst. The lead up was bad because I think we were like 0-10.
Oh, yeah.
Leading up too. And then it was working, and I'll never forget this till the day I die. The first convention that Quad M had worked was the Reno convention of 2014. Mm-hmm. It was that November. His rookie year, he got the start. Thursday night football. Well, he was already starting. He was starting the entire year.
Yeah.
Because it was supposed to be Matt Schaub.
Yeah.
And then he flaked out, and Carr was just fucking doing, lighting it up in the preseason. They said, all right, you got the start, kid.
Yep.
And that was the game against, it was Thursday night against the Chiefs. We got our first win. Latavius Murray had that breakout game of like, God, it was just crazy yards. I want to say it was like 240 or something like that. I mean, it was crazy fucking yards, two touchdowns, and just fucking lit shit up. And I was like, oh my God. And here we are just drunk in fucking Reno. I'm like, where's the betting counter? Right. I got to throw me in some money. But yeah, no, so this would be, because we're heading into the 2017 season.
So it was fourth year.
So 14, 15, 16, 17, yeah, so the three-year rookie contract, this would be the fourth year extension.
Okay. Yep.
Yeah, because I believe if you're a first-round draft pick, you're signed for 4 years with a fifth round with a fifth year option.
Mm-hmm.
And then
he wasn't a first round?
Oh no. No, he was the second pick of the second round.
Huh.
Yeah. No, first pick that year? Khalil Mack, motherfucker.
Oh.
That was the draft that set us up.
Really did.
Cuz that draft we got Khalil Mack. We got
Derek
Carr.
Y'all got some good scouts.
Oh,
scouts, yes. Need a round of applause.
Well, you know, well, and the thing is, you know, and a lot of the credit I will give to Reggie McKenzie. When he first got that general manager job, oh, dude, he was so fucking under fire the entire time.
Yeah.
Everyone was riding his ass, you know, oh my God, this team just sucks so bad, and you're cutting all of the good players. How can you be doing this? And I'm like, look at the crazy-ass money that Al Davis had set up for these players. There's no way. You can't. So I knew the first couple of years it was going to be, you know, it wasn't rebuilding.
Growing pains.
Oh, fuck, it wasn't even that. It was setting the dynamite along the base, you know, finding all the prime key structural points to set it up, and then blow the fucker down, tear it down, and then build back up. That draft of 2014, that was the rebuild. That was the beginning of the rebuild. Because, like I said, we picked up Khalil Mack in the first round. We got Derek Carr in the second round. And then we got Gabe Jackson, the offensive lineman, in the third round. And I'd like to see if we can't try to get him re-signed as well. But, no, that was when I says, okay, let's see what happens. And, that was a magical time. That was when all you bandwagon fans can eat a dick.
Eat a dick!
If you've been sitting through, there was a guy that I worked with, and he was a Raiders fan, huge Raiders fan. And, you know, I was talking about how, like, for the last 15 years, you know, our shit has just been sucking. And, he was quick to correct. He's like, fuck that, it's been 25 years. We only had three good ones in the meanwhile. And I sit there, had to look at it. I was like, oh, you know, you go back, 94, I think, was the last winning season we had had. And then up until, like, 2000, when, you know, Gruden and Gannon and all them had the fucking big run, you know, two really kick-ass playoff appearances, and then the goddamn Tuck Rule game.
Yeah.
And then that next year, we were in the Super Bowl, and then from there, it was the drizzling shits again. So, I will always sit there and say that, yeah, it was Al Davis. I'm not going to shit on him because of what he did for the league.
Mm-hmm.
But as far as, his old dementia-riddled ass needed to be gone, like, in the 90s. And that's why I laugh right now, because...
crazy.
Oh, dude. Jerry Jones in Dallas is becoming the new...
Al Davis?
Yeah. The thing is, though, his kids are stepping up a hell of a lot more, because they're like, we don't need to have this bullshit.
Yeah, poor Stewie. He just wanted to play with his trains in his bedroom.
So some quick numbers on the old Derek Carr signing. Okay. That's got me all just giddy like a little schoolgirl. Oh, okay. So 5 years, $125 million. At that point in time, at the time of this signing.
A lot of coin.
Oh, yeah. Now, he beat out Andrew Luck as being the highest paid player in NFL history.
Yep.
I loved his response because, of course, when I saw this, I was fucking just glued to the press conference. And, people were like, so what do you think? How do you feel about being the highest paid player of all time? He's like, I guess it feels good until the next one gets signed.
Right.
You know, because I mean, he fucking knows. I mean, it's that type of thing is bullshit. You know, it's what the market dictates.
Yeah.
You know, and he made comments that it was never about the money. I want to be a Raider. I want to sign a 20-year deal if I could. I want to be a Raider. And, it was kind of this thing where I was on vacation, and all of a sudden my agent calls, says, we got the shit done. I'm like, oh, okay, cool. What? Well, he didn't say shit because he's like major Christian. He's a milk-drinking kind of guy. He's a stand-up guy, which would be nice when we go to Vegas.
Yeah.
Because that way we can either see how steadfast in his beliefs he is, or how full of shit he is in the land of sin. This will be entertaining to find out, too.
Yeah.
How much control can you keep before he says, fuck it, I'm out. You know that 20-year deal I was talking about? Shove it up your ass.
Fuck yourselves.
And then, of course, there were, you know, key friends of ours who was saying that line was just a bunch of bullshit.
Yeah.
You know.
Goddamn, motherfucker.
It's bullshit.
But fuck the fucking noob.
He's fucking a noob.
Gay fish. He ain't fucking. He was all about the money the entire time. He just says that because he's Derek Carr. Trying to be the nice guy. Spend it all on Chick-fil-A in my ass.
All right, so $40 million of it is a full guarantee. So that 125, $40 million is a full guarantee.
Wow.
$70 million injury guarantee.
What?
So guess what?
If he gets hurt, he gets paid more.
That knee blows out and his career's over. He's still making bank.
Which, yeah.
So it sucks that we would not have a player, but you know, hey, good for him, because you know this is the franchise.
Yeah.
This is how you can tell when a dude is your franchise player.
Yep. This is the kind of stuff you give him.
$70 million injury guarantee. We will still pay your ass.
Wow.
$69 million is due in the first 3 years. So half of it, well over half, is going to be due in that first 3 year time frame.
Mm-hmm.
But here's the kicker. This is the part that kind of made me chuckle.
Mm-hmm.
Nevada doesn't have a state tax.
Wow.
So in 2 years.
When it crosses over.
When he goes to Nevada.
Yeah.
Think about how much more fucking money he's getting. That he doesn't have to pay out to Uncle Sam.
Dude, there's going to be so many players like, fuck yeah, I want to be a Raider.
What's that? Gambling? Hookers? All the drugs I can smoke, snort, and shoot? Plus no state tax?
And I get to play football? Fuck yeah.
That's why I hope Reggie McKenzie holds to his guns. You know, we don't need those goddamn troublemakers.
Oh shit!
But yeah, no. Now we just got to get Khalil Mack re-signed.
Resigned. Yep.
Because you know, on that NFL top 100 of all time, he was number 5. This right here, this was given to the number 11 player.
Yeah.
Number 5 player probably gonna want a little bit more. But I don't know if they're going to pay that much for a defensive player.
Well, I bet it's going to be comparable to whatever Von Miller got.
He'd have to make more than Von Miller.
Yeah.
Because, you know, one thing that Khalil Mack has done that Von Miller hasn't done.
Got selected to the Pro Bowl in two different positions?
In two different positions.
Yeah, that's impressive.
You know? I mean, don't get me wrong. You know, I got to fucking... We play Von Miller twice a fucking year.
Yeah.
You know, I can't stand
Von Miller's good.
Not, I can't stand him. Not it's nothing personal. Mm-hmm. It's strictly business.
Oh yeah.
If we fucking sign him, or he left the Broncos.
Fuck the Broncos. I fucking hate them.
Now how can you hate it, dude? You ought to be like all fucking like pissy about the Steelers.
I hate the Steelers
and the Ravens
too,
because they're better than you.
Yeah, I hate the fucking Ravens too. But I do hate the Broncos. They fucking suck.
Well, you know, to me, I think my hatred of the Broncos not just stems from the fact that I just can't stand them, but Broncos fans are more obnoxious than Yankees fans.
Oh, yeah. I'm well aware. When me and Kenzie went to the game, yeah, they were assholes.
Who? Oh, was it a Bengals?
Mm-hmm. Bengals-Broncos. Bengals-Broncos? Yeah, it was the last game of the season 2 years ago.
No, oh, that's right.
That was our kind of one of our wedding presents.
Yeah, I forgot about sister. Okay, yeah. Yeah, I remember that now.
Yeah.
Yeah, I forgot about that. But so you know as well, I mean, they are the most obnoxious fucking fans out there.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't even mean just in Denver proper. I mean
all over the world. They are just
horrendous. You know, and I mean, you know, don't take it personal. You know, it's one of those things where if we don't talk football, I could be your best friend in the world. Mm-hmm. But if you're a Broncos fan, do not fucking talk football with me.
I don't because
man, woman, or child, a closed fist will end up. No, actually, because you're a Broncos fan, it'll be open hand.
Because it's gonna get bitch slapped.
Because I use fists. I use fists for those that aren't bitches. Maybe that'll get a fucking response. Maybe I'll get some emails on that.
You might.
You bunch of bastards. All right. All right. So next item up for bid here, as we try to wrap up this second segment here. You enjoy the gaming.
I do.
You're a fan of the gaming and all that type of stuff. You know, what do you like to jam on a little bit there?
I've got an Xbox and I got a Nintendo DS.
You know, Jason and I have been... You know, waxing philosophical about that Nintendo Classic Edition that came out last year.
Yeah.
And how Nintendo kind of fucked us over with the whole, shorthanded production runs and all that bullshit. Mm. And then not, what's the word I'm looking for here? And then they decided to just cut our balls off in November saying we're not going to produce anymore.
Yeah.
Well, our prediction, we called it right. Super Nintendo Classic Edition is going to be coming out September 29th. And it's going to be running about $80. And I'm kind of on the fence about this.
Yeah.
I'm a little wee bit on the fence on this. It gives you 21 games, so it's not 30 like the last one was. Yeah. You know, it's $20 more than that NES Classic Edition, right? You get 21 games, but you do get two controllers, so you know, there's a little trade-off
there.
That's
nice.
And the games that they've got on here, the 21 games that they've got on here, are actually pretty well indicative of the best that the Super Nintendo put out at that time.
Yeah.
You got Contra 3, you got Donkey Kong Country, you got Earthbound, Final Fantasy 3, F-Zero, Kirby Superstar, Kirby Dream Course, Zelda Link to the Past, Mega Man X, Secret of Mana, Star Fox, the previously never before actually officially released Star Fox 2.
Cool.
Super Street Fighter 2, Turbo Hyper Fighting.
Yeah.
So the only thing that would make that game better is if it was the championship edition that had like the four bonus characters, Cammy.
Right. Yeah.
Because that makes me think of Kylie Minogue. And she's still hot. Longest running celebrity crush for old TJ.
For TJ?
Oh, I love me that Kylie Minogue. Pushing 50 and she's still just hot.
That's amazing.
Oh, God, yes. the gods of genetics kissed you on the nose that day.
So nice. Want to touch the hiney.
Super shit. Castlevania 4, Super Ghouls and Ghosts, Super Mario Kart, Super Mario RPG, Legend of the Seven Stars. Super Mario World, Super Metroid, Super Punch-Out, and Yoshi's Island.
Cool.
Very,
I like them.
All very, very, very good games. Yeah. I've got, you know, I could probably come up with, you know, a list of games that could probably play better, you know, than on that. But, you know, licensing being what it be, you know, like any of the Star Wars games.
God, that would have been nice.
They were hard as hell. They were hard as fuck, but they were good games.
They were fun, yeah.
God, what's another one? Chrono Trigger. You know, it's a... I would say arguably the best RPG on the system. But yeah, you could flip-flop between Final Fantasy and Chrono Trigger. I think that just amounts to taste.
Yeah.
But at the end, yeah, I mean, like I said, there's a shit ton of games on there. But, you know, as I'm looking, I'm thinking it, and I, you know, I got pros for this, and I got cons. Mm-hmm. And I don't know that I would go out and, you know, run out and get it.
Yeah.
Because number one, they're probably gonna fucking shortchange us like I did the last time. Oh, we only make so many copies. So sorry, Mac and Pig. So sorry, Mac and Pig dog.
We were so much, it don't matter.
But, you know, when I sit there and look at the numbers, like if you already have the Super Nintendo,
mm-hmm.
you know, for $86, you could go online and pick up the EverDrive, the Super EverDrive flash cart,
yep.
and get damn near every Super Nintendo game. Mm-hmm. I say damn near, I'm going to qualify that in a second. If you don't have the Super Nintendo, for about another 65 bones, you can get one on eBay.
Mm.
You know, so it's not, I mean, you know, so.
They're still out there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And people are donking them off. You know, and like I said, $60 more, okay. You know, if you don't have it, but it's worth it.
Yeah.
Now, that being said, the problem with a lot of these flash carts is that the Super Nintendo, their games, for a lot of their games, had what they called the Super FX chip.
Mm-hmm.
Which allowed them to either process shit faster, or you could have fake or faux 3D, you know, like Star Fox.
Star Fox, yep.
And they don't have the ability to emulate those FX chips on these flash carts yet. So, no Star Fox, no Mario Kart, I think. I don't know. I know that you would not be able to play the Mario RPG.
Yeah.
You know, so there's like 7 or 8 different games you would not guaranteed not be able to play with these flash cards.
Flash cards that are on this new console.
Right. And to me, like, Star Fox would kind of be a selling point there, you know, without having to go fucking track down the original game to have it on here. It's kind of a good selling point.
And Star Fox 2.
So I'm on the fence.
I kind of like the fact that it has the high definition cable.
The old HDMI, yeah.
That's kind of nice.
Yeah, and the two controllers. Yeah. You know, because like I said, with that old classic edition, you know, you're shelling out $60 plus like another $30 for the controller. So you're actually paying more doing that with that old classic edition than you are, you know, with this.
Yeah.
So I mean, it's a trade off. Like I said, the only reason that I'm like, so, oh my god, this is all, you know, do it. Is that they burned us with that old NES edition.
Being pricks about the old NES.
Yeah. Because, I mean, my thought is, why stop production on shit that people still want?
Mm-hmm.
Because all you're doing is helping out the fucking internet scalpers.
Oh, yeah.
Now, that's all you're doing.
Yeah. Maybe they're going to wait till Christmas and bring them both.
Oh, God, no, because that's when they're going to fuck us. That's what they did. They canceled the classic edition right before Christmas.
Yeah, that's why they're going to bring it back for this Christmas.
They shortchange you. Fuck yeah. Oh, we do this for you because we love our customers so much.
You can combine all the consoles into one giant console.
Here's what we do. We love you so much. We cancel Super Nintendo Classic Edition 2 months before Christmas.
You're welcome.
And then we fuck you a year later. GameCube Classic Edition.
GameCube was garbage.
Eat the penis.
Eat the penis.
You god bastards. But yeah, so, you know, like I said, I mean, if you're down with it, that's great. Maybe if they want, they can try to woo us back.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit of productive, you know, a little bit of better production run. That type of gig, but hey, be what it be.
I'm interested to see when they release the 64.
You know, I don't know. I wasn't really a fan of the N64.
I bet they have the wrestling game on it.
Well, yeah, I'm sure they do, but, you know, see, here...
That was one of the greatest wrestling games ever. I'm sorry.
I'm thinking part of that is the age difference. And there's not... Granted, there's only like 4 years age difference. Yeah. But you got to remember, that fucker came out... What was I, like 21? So you're probably like 16-ish.
Yeah.
You know, so, you know,
Is I played that game for many years, into my 20s.
Oh, sure. Well, I mean, I still fucking dig on Royal Rumble for the Super Nintendo.
Mm-hmm.
And that game honestly, in the long run, that's just a piece of shit game. But to me, it's, you know, you're talking junior high, you know, you're fucking talking junior year of high school, that was the weekend, you know, jamming on Colt 45. You know, playing that. That's how you killed a Friday night right there.
You remember the one on the Nintendo, the Starman or the
Claw? Pro Wrestling, yes. I actually have the original card for that.
That's awesome.
Oh, let me see. Can I remember? Okay, let me see if I can remember all of the characters on Pro Wrestling. Black Box Pro Wrestling. Fighter Hayabusa, Starman.
Mm-hmm.
Arguably the most racist character to ever be portrayed in a video game ever, Kin Korn Karn, the Mongolian, Korean, whatever the hell he was supposed to be, the Amazon, King Slender, and then there was like the real fucking tan dude. It wasn't Great Puma was the one you fought at the very, very, very end. He was like the boss guy. You could never play select him.
Yeah.
Giant. Oh, he was a fucking. He was the one that used the fucking claw on the dudes. He was like this cross between Hulk Hogan and Nick Bockwinkel. He was like all fucking tan and blonde, had the fucking cleft, the dimple chin, you know, and all that. And that was, he was supposed to be.
Reminded me of Ric Flair.
See, I thought King Slender reminded me more of Ric Flair because of the long hair.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
That's true.
But no, God, that's a fun game. The only problem with that game, though, is it's button mashing. Like, you cannot lock up and try to get anything accomplished.
No.
And once you get past a certain point, it becomes so difficult playing the computer that the only way you can hope to win is by running across the very top and wait for the dude to finally come up and then hit him with a clothesline and just do that until he's done.
And pin him.
And then, yeah. And so then, I think Tecmo World Wrestling for the Nintendo was a much better game.
I don't know if I ever played that one.
Let me know sometime. We'll crank. We'll fire it up, fucker.
All right.
But
it's not the NTZ, but
it's okay. Do what we needed to do. Okay. So, real quick here. You know what? I'm gonna save this. I'm gonna save this for my pick of the week. I'll give us a little bit more for pick of the week. So, at this point in time, let's go ahead here. We'll take a quick break.
Okay.
Get a little horrible moments, and a quick pick of the week, and get this shit done. All right, it's Quantum Show, kids. Stay tuned.
In a city where corruption rules the streets, only one man can stop the serial killer known as the Blood Bandit. James Kurt, a former police officer turned private investigator, must race against the clock to stop the madman before he achieves his ultimate diabolical goal. When JK's brother Alex is thought killed in the line of duty and mysteriously returns with no memory of his past life, the stakes are raised even higher. Enigma, the comic book series from Quad M Productions, written and illustrated by TJ Damon, with colors and effects by Jason Vickers. Enigma. Order your copy at quadmproductions.com today.
You're listening to the Quad M Show. Segment 3.
Welcome back to the third and final segment of this here Quad M Show. Again, we are your hosts. I am TJ.
And I'm Marty.
Losers, in other words.
Well. And this segment is brought to you in part by DeeplyDapper.com. Now, you've heard me go on about all the sweet merch that you can pick up at DeeplyDapper.com. Original art prints and books, vinyl wrapped metal flasks, custom key hangers and light switch plates, as well as those handmade soaps. All based on your favorite Nerdvolt properties. But there's so much more. Get your nary ass over to DeeplyDapper.com today. Check out the 3D Pod Casket and the Robot Kraken Podcasts.
It's good stuff.
He does. He does good work all the way around. That's why I'm so damn jealous of him.
All successful and shit.
Well, hey Marty, did you know they've been posting recipes on the website there as well?
I have not.
Yeah, I went and looked. Yeah, he's even putting out like his own recipes on there.
Cool.
This guy is like this guy is a damn renaissance man, our good buddy Chris. So what's your excuse, people? Get on out there today. DeeplyDapper.com. That's DeeplyDapper.com. DeeplyDapper, better living through tentacles. Tentacles. Oh, all right. Well, let's go ahead here. Let's get this last segment here going. Let's have a little bit of horrible moments in Marty history, shall we?
And now it's time for horrible moments in Marty history.
Yeah, sure.
Marty, what do we got on the agenda this week?
Well, this week is going to take you back to a little time. It was about November 20th of 1999.
You have the date on this, too?
Dude.
Was this somebody's birthday?
No.
Oh,
this
okay.
This was Thanksgiving break, my first year of college.
Okay.
Yeah. And me and my buddy, we decided to do something a little crazy,
you know, because
we're crazy college kids. That's what we do. So we happened to acquire some magic mushrooms.
Oh, geez, it's another fucking drug story.
Told you, horrible moments in Marty history. You too can prevent a forest fire. So anyway, we got some mushrooms, and we're like, well, what are we going to do? We can't just sit around and eat these mushrooms at home, which in retrospect is probably what we should have done.
Okay.
Because we thought it'd be a better idea to go to a movie.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
On mushrooms.
Okay, hold on. Dare I ask which movie?
Oh, of course. I have to tell you which movie. That's part of the story.
Okay.
So, the movie is Sleepy Hollow.
Oh, Jesus.
I don't know if you have ever heard the term bad trip. But I'm telling you, if you watch Sleepy Hollow on mushrooms in a movie theater, it's a pretty safe bet you're going to have a bad trip. It's not really a calming, peaceful type of movie.
Okay, please.
Really tugs at the heartstrings. It's more a, hey, fuck you up, Tim Burton movie. Which, you know, Tim Burton, he probably was thinking people are going to be on mushrooms when they watch this. So that's
any
why
Tim
he,
Burton movie on mushrooms is not a good idea.
Dude. It was quite a time.
Okay, so please to elaborate.
Okay, yeah. So we just left my house, which was in Clancy at the time, and we're driving down the dirt road, and we're like, well, we're going to eat these mushrooms now, so that way when we get to the movie theater, we sit down, we'll be good to go.
Okay, so you took the back road into town as opposed to driving on the interstate.
Yeah, we took the frontage road.
Okay.
But, yeah, so we eat these, we drive, we make it all the way there, you know, it's no problem. I mean, it sucked because it tasted like complete garbage, and you want to throw up after you eat them. You're like, whoa, this is a bad idea, but thank God they're in my belly now. Give me lots of pop to drink it down. Mountain Dew.
Wash it down.
Wash it down with some dew. Because we're crazy. Yeah.
So, you crazy college kids, you.
So we get to the movie theater, we're fine, we sit down. And no more than 10 minutes after we sit down, shit starts fucking happening.
Shit gets real.
Like, both our pupils just completely dilate. We're getting weird goosebumps all over. The walls are breathing. And, yeah, so that was right when we sat down. That was going on. But we had our popcorn. We had our pop. We were good, you know. We're going to fucking watch this movie. It's going to be awesome. And we're going to be completely fine. But no, the movie does start, and probably no more than 20 minutes into the movie. Granted, this movie was just released.
That's why we know the date so well.
That's the reason why we know the date so well.
Premiere. Okay, yeah. Okay. All right.
And for some reason, I had it stuck in my head that I had already seen the movie. Like, maybe I had a dream or something, or I had watched it before.
I don't know what I was thinking, but I was completely twisted on drugs, apparently.
Wow, man.
Because I was like, oh, man, I know that. I kept on turning to my buddy, and we're in the movie theater is completely packed. And I keep turning to my buddy, and I'm like, man, I've seen this before. Where have I seen this before? And he's like, shut up, man.
Shut up, man.
I'm on drugs, too. It's fucking freaking me out. So I rant and rave about how I've watched this movie all the way up until the end of the movie, like 5 minutes before the end. I turn to my buddy and I say, I think I need a doctor. And he's like, what? And I get up and I walk away. And he's just sitting there like, what the fuck just happened? Think you need a doctor. But no, I was having like an incredible like fucking intestinal pain or something. Or it's what I thought. It turned out I just had to pee. So I go, I pee, I don't look at myself in the mirror because weird shit's going on. Because
you don't want to see those Medusa hairs. Yeah, you know,
I don't
want to
see my face melting or all this craziness. But by the time I get done peeing and I come out, the movie's over and people are walking out, so I just stand like in the middle of the aisle and let people walk by me, whereas my buddy's still just sitting in his seat. And I'm just I don't know how I did it, but yeah, then I just walk back to him and we're the only ones left in the theater, and we're like, oh shit, man. And he's like, what the fuck, why would you? I was like, I had to pee. So, sorry I freaked you out, hope I didn't trip you out too much. Yeah, and then we had to drive back home, and we're like, we must have sat in the parking lot for fucking 30 minutes, and then we drove from that parking lot to the McDonald's parking lot, because this was at the old circus theater.
Right.
So we like parking lot jumped. Probably took us an hour, and then finally
for half a block.
Started seeing okay, or what I thought, or I was having a valley probably, or a valley. I was coming down, so I was like, let's jam home. And then we drove to his house and then proceeded to stare at his ceiling and watch it breathe. And that, kids, is why you don't do drugs.
Just say no.
Just say no. Pretty sure. No, that's a lie. I did do mushrooms again after that. But yeah, I've only done them a handful of times, and yeah.
Well, that begs the question: did you ever partake in Sleepy Hollow again, so you could see how the fucker ended?
Oh, I did. Yeah.
Or even just be able to watch the fucking movie.
I did. I watched the movie, and I was like, wow, this movie's way different when you're on mushrooms. Yeah, it was a good time though. Yeah. Jesus, it's amazing I'm still alive.
well, that's because the good Lord wanted you to be able to tell your stories of woe.
Right? I know. I'm doing a service right now.
That's exactly it. It's what we do for you kids out there.
Horrible moments.
Let him have the horrible moments so you don't have to.
Yeah. Learn from my mistakes, people.
Oh, all right. Well, good sir, do you have any picks of the week for the week this week?
No. Just go out and enjoy the sun, unless it's 120 degrees, but...
Or me. You
know, or you, TJ.
Having to slog away, fucking dealing with a bunch of bullshit.
Yeah. Maybe go out and dance.
Go and have yourself a...
Go do a shuffle.
Go.
No, two-foot shuffle. Or you can come to Bowser's and do a little jig.
Oh.
I'll crank the radio up.
Phrase that pays this week.
Oh. Phrase that pays.
Sleepy Hollow. Let's go ahead and just keep it simple.
That's a good
we'll
one.
We'll go Sleepy Hollow. Because last week's was pretty long-winded.
It was. Yeah.
Shane Black told me I have a
giant...
pussy as big as a bread box or some shit. I don't remember
either. That was a long time ago.
That was a lifetime ago.
Many beers. And
all right. So my pick of the week for the week this week comes to us by way of our good friend, old Jamie Bronson.
Mm-hmm.
Well, see, him and his wife, they have a nephew, and his name is Micah, and he has himself a channel out on YouTube called Drawing with Micah, the artistic autistic.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, this is going to be a little bit of a rant, a little bit of a bitch session here too, because Micah, much like the Quad M Show, has suffered from the YouTube bullshit copyright infringement policy horseshit fucking thing.
Discrimination.
Oh God, dude, these guys piss me off. Anybody that's a YouTube video publisher, content provider, whatever you want to call it,
mm-hmm.
everybody knows what, you know, did, I get frustrated even fucking talking about it a second time. I do, man. I mean, like I said, it drives me up a goddamn wall. So what it boils down to here is that Micah had started up recording, or he was doing videos about some of the artwork that he creates.
Uh-huh.
And his intent was, there was some of his artwork he was going to sell in order to try to raise money for, like, some kind of autistic, you know, charity, autistic research, you know, doing some charitable fucking work here.
Yeah.
And he started putting the videos out, and these included such videos as Black Mouse in Red Pants, and Space Robot, and Fish Looking for Something, whatever. But you could tell it was fucking Mickey Mouse and R2-D2 and Finding Nemo that he was doing, right? Uh-huh. It wasn't, like, a big secret here. It was pretty fucking obvious. And he puts it out, and then all of a sudden he gets slapped with the YouTube, we're shutting these videos down. Mm. Now, from what Jamie and his wife were telling me, you know, that the word they got was, they actually got a letter from Disney. I'm thinking it was just the YouTube, you know, the bullshit YouTube letter on that. And to me, it frustrates me, you know, for two key big reasons. You know, number one, the kid's just trying to raise some money for a charitable cause.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, that to me, you know, you should be able to make some level of, you know, some level of what's the word I'm looking for here? Concession,
mm-hmm.
for that. But unfortunately, because YouTube is all about using bullshit algorithms, you know, like, fucking our show has been dinged like 3 or 4 times because of the bumper music.
Yeah.
You know, and I think one of them, they said, no way in hell, we're not lifting this.
Mm-hmm.
And it's bullshit, because I would get these fucking flags like 5 minutes after I posted the video. There's no way in hell these guys have actually listened to and seen what's going on.
Yeah.
But they all base it on the algorithm's never wrong. Yes, motherfuckers, the algorithm's wrong, especially in the case of Micah, the artistic autistic.
Yeah.
Because for two reasons. Number one, trying to fucking raise the money for a charitable cause. And number two, and I speak to this from my own personal experience,
mm-hmm.
from my years now working in the industry and of comic book conventions and all this type of stuff. You walk down Artist Alley of any comic book convention, every artist who is actually, you know, like drawing prints and making shit, they are selling created works of licensed properties that are not theirs.
Yeah.
Okay. You can walk down. You got, you at any point in time, you got Batman, Spider-Man, the Avengers, Turtles, Star Wars, Star Trek. You fucking name it, you can find it. And if you can't find it, you can get a commission done. Yeah. And they'll do it. You know, I mean, across the board, these guys, because they're starving artists. They're just trying to, you know, they're just, this is how they're making a living.
Yeah.
And Marvel, DC, you know, your comic book property owners don't say shit.
Yeah.
Because they understand, they, you know, and honestly, they don't care. Because to them, and I actually talked about this with when I was working a show in Vegas.
Mm-hmm.
And the guy who was working the booth to my left, he was working a booth for his son, while his son was doing a show in Chicago. So that's a racket. If I can get that going, have somebody else work a show while you're doing all
that. Help
me
out, Pop.
Come on, Dad. But I asked him, I says, how are these guys getting away with this? You know, how are they able to do that and not get, you know, get shut down by, you know, the mouse or the rabbit?
Mm-hmm.
And he says flat out, he's like, they just look at it as, you know, they look at it as free advertisement. Mm-hmm. You know, they understand these guys are just trying to make money and possibly, hopefully, get jobs doing cover art or whatever. But at the end of the day, it's free publicity, free promotion, whatever. The only thing that they'll crack down on is actually, you know, solid merchandise like T-shirts and hats and that type of thing.
Yeah.
You know, unless you are, like, say, a licensed vendor, they're not going to say shit.
Yeah.
Okay? So for YouTube or whomever to crack down on this kid, again, Drawing with Micah, the Artistic Autistic, that's the channel on YouTube for him.
Yeah, I was just watching it.
To crack down on this kid when
pretty funny.
Hundreds of artists are out there every weekend doing the same thing for, and I'm not to be a dick when I say this, because but for their own profit, and yet we're going to crack down on a kid for trying to raise money for a charity.
Yeah,
you know, that's bullshit.
That is bullshit.
And Marty just went and saw the video on this, and you know, you know it's pretty fucking cool.
It is. It's cute.
It's just him sitting on the couch, and he's on the bed, and he's got the green screen on the back, and it shows the picture, and he's got like some kind of crazy, you know, little fake voiceover on the side going, "Oh no, you can't sell that." Well, why not? You know, and it rings. I thought it was a great way to rail against the machine that is YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and they say they got the letter from Disney. I don't know about that. I think it was just the YouTube deal. But like in that video, it even says, "We love you, Disney. Please don't sue us."
Yeah.
But, you know, at the end of the day, kids, I would just say my pick of the week is go check out Drawing with Micah, the Artistic Autistic. Check him out. Give him some support. Give him some likes. Give him some, you know, solid comments. Show some support, you know, and let him know that, hey, you know, don't be dissuaded because of the douchebaggery of the tube of you.
Yeah.
Now, granted, no. I love going on YouTube. I'm a YouTube whore, watching the videos and all that. But when it comes from the side of the content providers, they frustrate the hell out of me, and a lot of other guys as well. So it be what it be. But there's that. So, anyways, good sir, do we have anything left to pimp, promote, propagate, or pander for the week?
I don't think so.
All right. Well, that will wrap it up for this week's episode of the Quad M Show. You know, hey, kids, don't forget, subscribe to us on either iTunes or Android. Make sure when you do, review, rate, all that type of stuff. It is very important. Also, get out there, like us on the Facebook, and follow us on the Twitter. Either website, just use Quad M Comics.
What was that new pod thing also?
Oh, the Pod Chaser.
Pod Chaser, yeah.
Don't forget, beta.podchaser.com, and then use the magic key, Quad M.
Quad M. Do it.
Get in there. All right, so until next week, kids, this is TJ.
And this is Marty.
And we will see you all later. Take care.
Stay classy.
You've been listening to the Quad M Show. Copyright 2017, Quad M Productions. If you have any comments, questions, queries, quibbles, or concerns, email us at quadmcomics@gmail.com or find us on Twitter at @quadmcomics.
I'm Lewis, the lifeguard, and happy to say I rescued a drowning potato today. They drowned it in sour cream. Oh, what a shame, 'cause food's so much better when it's practically plain. So don't drown your food in mayo, salt, ketchup, or goop.